Welcome back to After the Fact. I'm Christian Esguera. An advisor to President Duterte urges the president to throw his support behind the presidential bid of Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr. Presidential Advisor for Political Affairs Secretary Jacinto Parra says Marcos will likely remain loyal to Duterte and would be the best one to protect him from supposedly trumped-up charges when he steps down from office. But online, some social media users slammed Parras for openly suggesting what they believe is a self-serving move. Others pointed out it's not part of the president's job to protect their predecessors. We're now joined by Secretary Jacinto Parras, who is the political advisor of President Rodrigo Duterte. Good evening, sir, and thank you for joining us on the program.
Yes, hi, Christian. It's been some time now since
it's been a while.
We last talked, and I'm so glad that you're giving me the opportunity to be your guest tonight.
Okay, pag-usapan po natin to, no? So you are pushing President Duterte, you're encouraging him to actually endorse former Senator Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos's presidential bid. Is that correct?
Well, being the presidential advisor of the president, you know, it's my job to really get the people's view on politics, to get our political leaders' opinions. And it has come to a point that even the biggest party, the PDP Laban, has in fact officially endorsed Bongbong Marcos. So I would be remiss on my job if I will not give my, suggestion to the president of what is present on the ground, no? Although the president in our last cabinet meeting where I was present, he said that he will stay neutral unless for compelling reason that he will really have to endorse.
Well, when was this cabinet meeting?
Well, I think this was it's a semi-cabinet meeting and talk to the people. You know, this where our health officials are able to present the state of the pandemic. So at that occasion, I was able to give the president the bird's eye view of what's going on in our country. And at that time, he said he'd rather stay neutral, and unless for a compelling reason, he will have to endorse someone. And to me, at this time, I feel that this is a compelling reason for him to finally endorse a candidate, because it's less than 2 months away from the election, and
Sir,
the administration has not find a candidate of its own. So
okay, let me get this clear, Secretary Parras. So, ano po yung sa tingin niyo compelling reason for him to endorse a presidential candidate now?
Well, I feel that it's necessary for him to support the candidate, because sayang naman, no? Ang ating Pangulo, ang kanyang performance rating is so high. Ang kanyang popularity rating has remained very high. So, ibig sabihin yan, tumitingala pa rin, malaking respeto, malaking loyalty ang ating mga taong bayan kay Pangulo. So, he carries a big weight in terms of endorsement.
Okay.
So,
pero bakit po ano?
10 to 20% he can uh-oh, he can lead his loyal people to make a difference in the victory of a certain candidate.
Okay, pero why are you pushing for his endorsement of Bongbong Marcos? Why Bongbong Marcos?
Well, I feel that Bongbong Marcos is the right candidate to endorse the president. First, I feel that loyalty and friendship is very important between two people. The president, in real politics has one way or another has done favors to the Marcos family. And Aimee Marcos and Bongbong has been allies to the president during his term. So feeling ko, my feeling is that Marcos would be the right person to be given the support of the president.
Well, when you say right, what do you mean? Right for the president?
I'm saying that he is the right person that the president should give his endorsement to support.
Pero ang binanggit ko kasi kanina rin sa press conference, no? So
yes,
this would be beneficial to President Duterte. In what way?
Well, among other things, you know, even before this election is gonna happen, there are already so many accusations against the president. False accusations, was accused of this and that. And for all these accusations, wala namang mga grounds, but the people who were responsible for accusing him, maligning him, are with one party, no? Para sa akin, political reality, the fight now boils down to two candidates.
Who are these candidates?
Between Bongbong and Lenny Robredo, because Lenny has been now the second runner based on survey. So I feel that if the president's adversaries who had been doing things against him while he was still in governance will continue. Much more if the candidate that they are supporting now will become president, the more reason that they will strike on the president.
Okay, you know, so in short, if you don't want the president to get into trouble, if you want to save his neck, so to speak, he should endorse Bongbong Marcos, not anyone else.
Well, naturally, the president would endorse somebody who is very close to him, because the daughter is the vice presidential candidate. So it's pretty obvious that why would he look for somebody else? Eh, nando na yung anak niya.
Pero hindi po ba telling yon?
Are very close together in this fight.
We understand that. Pero hindi po ba telling yun na hindi nag-i-endorse si President Duterte ng kandidato, more so hindi niya in-endorse si Bongbong Marcos at this point or even this late in the campaign, kahit na yun ang presidential candidate ng anak niya? Isn't that telling?
No, not at all. The president is waiting for his options. And it was led by the PDP Laban, which is his party. They endorsed the candidacy of Bongbong. So naturally, yung mga allies ng ating Pangulo ay nakasuporta na kay Bongbong Marcos. So why would the president be supporting somebody else when his allies are already supporting somebody?
Okay,
close to him, di ba?
Pero yung proposal nyo for President Duterte to endorse Bongbong Marcos, hindi po ba siya self-serving? Kasi ang argument dyan is para hindi siya makulong o hindi mag-prosper, for example, yung ICC case.
That's just one of the reasons that was singled out. But I did just have a chance to really say the other reasons why the president should endorse Bongbong Marcos. There are other reasons.
Okay, pero before we go to the other reasons, did you say that? Na kung ayaw mong hindi makulong, best chance mo si Bongbong Marcos.
Hindi makulong.
I mean, hindi mag-prosper yung mga kaso.
Don't twist the words. I did not say hindi makulong. I was saying that he would be prevented from being harassed by people who will file trump up charges. Iba yung makulong. The president will never be in prison because there are no grounds against him.
Okay. So kung ayaw niyo maharas si President Duterte, your proposal is for him to endorse Bongbong Marcos.
Well, he has to choose an ally. That's a natural, you know, it's a natural, it's a human factor in maski ako, if may kalaban ako, I will call for my big brother to fight against my enemies, di ba?
Pero nga, hindi po ba niyan self-serving? Kasi tinitingnan mo lang yung beneficyo sa'yo personally.
Because he has a choice eh. And that choice is just one of the many other reasons why he should support Bongbong Marcos.
So ano po yung reason? Ano po yung ibang reason? Bakit kailangan suportahan si Bongbong Marcos?
Bongbong Marcos stands tall among other candidates.
Yeah. Like how?
He's very qualified. He has been a senator. He has been a governor. He has been a congressman. So all those factors give him experience, no? Except for mga accusations that are still to be proven and
like
are still pending in several forums.
Ano po yung mga accusations na pending pa?
What is clear is that Bongbong has the experience to become president.
Opo. Pero if I may ask, ano po yung mga accusations kay Bongbong na pending?
Well, he has a pending disqualification case in the COMELEC, which he already won in the division.
Okay.
So, in that, pero, it proves something that wala siyang kasalanan. Oh.
Okay. Pero hindi po ba he owes the government real estate taxes ang valuation ngayon is 203 billion pesos. Hindi po ba totoo yan?
Well, that's what the BIR say. But that is still contestable.
Kasi pero ibig sabihin, meron siyang dapat bayaran.
It is only brought out now when these cases had been for years. Ilang presidente na yung nag-ano. Tapos ngayon, i-raise mo yung mga issues na yan dahil lamang na lamang sa kandidatura niya. And you want to put him off, hindi naman fair yun, di ba?
Oh, hindi po. Pero hindi rin po ba unfair sa taong bayan naman na merong masisingil na ganong kalaking pera, pero hindi binabayaran isang kandidato?
There is no evidence to show that Bongbong is not gonna pay. Maybe he's just delayed and maybe he will just, be able to act on it.
Pero Mr. Secretary, it's been several years. Ang tagal na po namatay ng father niya. And he's the executor and co-administrator. At hindi niya po binabayaran. I mean, these questions, I hope you won't take offense. These are legitimate questions na dapat itanong, di ba? So factual po yan. Oo.
Well, I cannot speak for Bongbong. This is just one of probably the many things that he's being accused of which has no basis. Maybe
nga po, ulitin ko, hindi po pwedeng palampasin na walang basis kasi nga po napakaliwanag ng record. Hindi po binabayaran yung real estate tax. So forgive me for challenging you because that is not factual what you're saying. It's not a mere allegation. Talagang hindi po siya nagbabayad pa ng estate tax. It's
well,
on record.
That is your allegation.
It's not my allegation, it's the record.
But his lawyer is saying otherwise.
Of course, they can contest that. Pero ang point, meron sila ang payable.
So, your word is against mine.
No. We're talking about records.
I'm saying that Bongbong Marcos, as a lawyer, and the lawyer says, this may not be 100% certain that this thing is true.
So wala siyang dapat bayaran.
Why is it being raised now?
No, let's not talk about the timing. Opo. Ang gusto ko pong tanungin sa inyo, wala po ba siyang dapat bayaran na estate tax?
Well, according to the BIR, he owes that much. But it's not over naman. Otherwise the BIR, kung talagang due na yan and demandable, the BIR could have also filed another case against him.
So ano po yung debatable? Yung ano po yung debatable? Yung amount o yung dapat may bayaran? Tingnan po, ano po yung debatable? Yung valuation, yung amount, o yung dapat may bayaran siya in the first
yung
place?
Yung timing ng babayaran. Baka hindi pa siya talagang inano ng BIR na the time for you has already been foreclosed and that you have to pay. The fact na hindi pa siya sinigil is the BIR has given him ample time to pay.
Pero sinabi na po ng ano,
before diba? You know it, Bongbong Marcos, Bongbong is just the administrator of the estate.
Executor din po.
The one who owes the money. So, it's his family. So, baka malay natin na babayaran niya yan or whatever. Okay. I don't know. I cannot speak for himself. I'm
I know you cannot speak for him, but my point is, let's not twist the facts. Kasi nga, executor siya, tapos co-administrator, tapos yan ang paliwanag. Mm. You need to answer these questions kasi kayo nagpo-push kay President Duterte to actually endorse him.
Eh. I'm answering you the question. Opo, sabi ko, perhaps the BIR has not really, collected it yet.
Hindi nga po makolekta kasi hindi nagbabayad. Meron na pong sulat ng BIR at sinasabi siningil sila. Ang BIR na nagsabi niyan, yung appointee ni President Duterte. That's factual. Okay, let's move to the other one. Diba sinasabi niyo, allegations. Hmm. Allegations sa pabubuhay, yung papuba yung Supreme Court decision ng 2003 kung saan na-forfeit ang at least $650 million in Swiss bank deposits by the Marcoses. Isn't that factual or to you that's still an accusation?
Well, I'm not the lawyer of Marcos. I'm just, you are asking me to be interviewed because of my statement that the president is gonna endorse. I'm not lawyering for Bongbong Marcos in this program. So if there are issues that you're raising that is gonna be answered by his lawyer, I'm not competent to answer your questions. If you're gonna ask me questions that are relevant purpose for which you are inviting me, I will answer you.
I understand, Congressman Paras. Kaya ako po siya naitanong kasi binanggit niyo po kanina yung nagsanga-sanga na po, di ba? Dahil pinag-uusapan natin yung endorsement.
Yes, yes.
Kasi binanggit niyo, meron siyang mga accusations against him. So kailangan natin isa-isahin yun. Okay, let's move on po. No? So, you're pushing for President Duterte to support Bongbong Marcos. Pero sinabi niya na previously na Bongbong Marcos is a weak leader. Tapos, di ba, he made certain statements to the effect na mayroong isang kandidato na into drugs. And people were thinking he was referring to Bongbong Marcos. So, how can you expect him to endorse him now, given those statements that he had before?
Well, the president has not categorically stated sino ito. You yourself have said that he might be referring to somebody else, might not be referring to Bongbong Marcos.
He's a drugs
po. You're the one putting words to the president.
No, I'm not putting words into his mouth. Pwede nyo i-google ngayon. Sinabi ko nga, hindi niya pinangalanan yung sinasabi niyang nasa drugs, okay? Pero, he made it clear yung weak leader si Bongbong Marcos. So how would you reconcile that to your proposed endorsement?
Well, maybe at the time, he thought that he was a weak leader, but now that during the campaign, he was able to observe that Bongbong is not, after all, a weak leader. So he's entitled to change his mind.
Hmm. Kayo ba, sir? Are you endorsing Bongbong Marcos?
Yes, I am endorsing Bongbong Marcos after I have realized that he deserves to win this election.
Okay. Pero what more can President Duterte add to Bongbong Marcos kung at least based on the surveys, mataas na yung number niya? So ano pang benefit kung endorse ni President Duterte?
Well, it will seal the victory of Bongbong. That's my personal view because the president can add 10 to 20% more. He has an endorsement capability which carries a certain number of votes that will add up. You know, and the election is still going to come on May 9th. So many things can still happen. I admitted that Leni Robredo, in fairness to her, she's inching in. You know, she has large crowds. Yeah. So if you recall, in the last election, presidential election, Duterte only was able to go up towards the end, sometime in March. Grace po was leading in the pack. But na overtake. So if there is a chance that somebody can can provide a sure victory, like an endorsement of the president, why not tap it, di ba? Okay. And that's how I see it.
You don't want that to happen to Bongbong Marcos. You don't want that to happen to Bongbong Marcos. What happened to Grace Poe in 2016?
Yeah, of course.
You may nakahabol.
Why should someone who deserve it, like Grace Poe, she deserves to win also, no? Kasi maayos naman na tao si Grace Poe. Kaso nga, ang taong bayan, mahal na mahal nila si Pangulong Duterte, kaya na-overtaken siya.
So, okay. Mm-mm. Secretary Jing Paras, thank you very much for joining us tonight. Maraming salamat po and thank you for answering our questions.
Thank you rin. Thank you rin, Chris. Thank you for the debate.
Hindi naman, interview lang po yan. Okay. So that's it for tonight. This has been your host, Christian Esguerra. You can watch this episode again on iWantTFC or listen to our podcast on Spotify. Now for recaps and other exclusive content, subscribe to the ANC YouTube channel and catch up with us on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. See you again tomorrow, After the Fact.